What's going on, you guys? TBR here, back yet again with another 7 Nights 2 video. And in today's video, we are going to be breaking down the 1222 update. As you guys are probably aware, we have our newest legendary that's been added into the game in the form of Legendary Chris. So we're going to take a look at him and see if he's going to be worth your hard-earned rubies. And then we're also going to be taking a look at some new in-game events, as well as the update to the Celestial Tower. But before we get into all of that and more, make sure if you guys haven't already done so that you smash that like button and subscribe. And with all that out of the way, cue the intro. And as always, you guys, if you want links to any of this information for yourselves, links to the official forum posts will be in the description. But let's go ahead and get into the update, and we're going to start off here with the events. So as you guys can see in the in-game events tab, we are going to have a couple of new events here. First one is going to be the Happy New Year check-in event, and this one here is going to end up culminating after 7 days in giving us 5 of the selected Raid Up Hero summon tickets. This is particularly great for those of you out there who are still trying to chase after your favorite Legendary Plus character, as it is very tough to come by these tickets, so the fact that they are giving us 5 of these for free is really nice. In general, as far as the rest of what's on here, you are going to be able to pick up a rare Legendary accessory summon voucher. You're also going to be able to pick up this 10 times equipment summon ticket, so you're going to be able to get a multi, which is always nice for your equipment summons, as well as some elixirs and some runes. So in general, you guys, this isn't a bad login, especially considering the fact that all you've got to do is open up the game every day in order to pick up these rewards. So good stuff overall. Especially love to see these raid up summon tickets, because again, those are very rare that we get those. Now, as far as what else is in here, we are also going to have the Nightmare Tracker Chris upgrade support tab, and this is going to give us, of course, some different rewards depending on how well we're able to build up our newest Legendary Chris. So as you guys can see here, this is pretty much standard fare for what we've come to expect with these types of upgrade support missions. Not much to talk about there. You're going to get a bunch of gold, you're going to get a bunch of elixirs, and so on and so forth. And of course, the final reward, if you're able to get your Chris to level 46, you're going to get 20 of his soul stones. So good stuff nonetheless. Overall, not too much here to talk about. Like I said, this is really just going to be some stuff to keep us busy. We're going to have the newest play event as well. Now, this one here is going to give us various rewards depending on if we are doing all these different daily missions. So you'll want to go through here and make sure you do this stuff. None of it is anything too crazy, so it should be fairly easy. The final reward here, of course, is going to be a Legendary Armor Summon voucher, which is always going to be welcome. But in general, you guys, pretty good stuff overall. Not too much to talk about here. Just make sure that you go through, check these missions out, and make sure that you're doing all those, because you definitely want to make sure you are taking advantage of all these rewards. But that is pretty much going to do it for the newest in-game events, you guys. The next thing I want to go ahead and talk about is going to be the update to the Celestial Tower, because they have added 10 new tiers to the tower. And as you guys can see here, we have gotten to level 60 on ours, so we will be able to go ahead and start on the newest floors today. But if we go ahead and take a look here, of course, we can see that we are going to get a bunch of gold for level 61. We're going to get some clear tickets here, which these clear recharge tickets are of the utmost importance. These are extremely rare and extremely valuable. Typically, you're only going to be able to get these through things such as buying packages. So that's a really nice reward there. 800 maps here for Field of Exploration for tier 63 is fantastic. I know I've had a lot of people commenting about wanting more maps. Well, there you go, you guys. Go ahead and clear tier 63 of the Celestial Tower, and you are going to have a ton of the normal maps for the Field of Exploration. You're also going to be able to get some enhancement stones. Looks like here we're going to be able to get some hero summon tickets, as well as some rubies for tier 65. And then, of course, you are going to go ahead and be able to get your different crafting items for some of your legendary equipments. And then this is all going to culminate in the final tier right now that is open, which is tier 70, and this is going to give you, of course, those juicy rubies, but more importantly, that Legendary Plus Armor Summon voucher there is going to be the final reward for tier 70. So in general, you guys, obviously I haven't had a chance to sit down and play through these yet, but I will be taking some time over the course course of the next few days in order to clear this out again. So, fingers crossed I'm able to get through and get all the way through tier 70 of this thing and get all these rewards, because they are juicy this time around. The Celestial Tower tends to be jam-packed with value as far as these items are concerned. So, definitely want to make sure that you're going through every day and playing the Celestial Tower. We've talked about the importance of this in past videos, but in general, it's really nice to see that Netmarble has already added 10 new tiers to this thing, because this is a very important resource for all of us in getting these different in-game currencies and items. So great stuff overall, you guys. Time will tell, like I said, how difficult this ends up being. I didn't really find that many hangups playing through the initial 60 floors of this thing, so I'll be interested to see just how the overall progression scales and difficulty scales as we go through here, and I'll be sure to bring you guys a video if I find it to be something that is going to be informative and important to the community. But in general, that is going to be the Celestial Tower update. Now, with all of that out of the way, you guys, another thing I wanted to point out here, we do have this really cool new splash screen over in the general shop area. As you guys can see, it is now snowy, and it is going to be a winter wonderland here, so pretty cool stuff. I'm glad that they are celebrating the Christmas holiday with some of this stuff. It's pretty cool to see. But the thing we want to talk about here, because nobody's here to talk about that, instead what we want to talk about is the newest legendary to be added into the game, and that is of course going to be Nightmare Tracker Chris. So let's go ahead and take a look at Legendary Chris and see if he is going to be worth pulling for. Now, one thing that I want to go ahead and address with Legendary Chris real fast before we get into the kit is going to be the fact that I've had a lot of people messaging me about him being a little bit confused, because a lot of people out there are confused as to the release of this character and thinking that he is Legendary Plus Chris or so on and so forth. Legendary Plus Chris is a completely different character. I know that a lot of you guys out there have heard a lot of rumblings and a lot of people talking about Legendary Plus Chris over the past several months leading up to even just the release of the game, because Legendary Plus Chris is a very popular character. However, do keep in mind, this is a very different version of this character. This has no connection whatsoever to Legendary Plus Chris. That is going to be a separate release at some point in the future, so kind of keep that in mind. I had gotten a few messages from people kind of confused on that, so I just wanted to make sure I cleared that up. So two completely different characters, and while Legendary Plus Chris is going to be an extremely powerful unit down the road, Legendary Chris in his own right is still very strong. So let's go ahead and get into the kit, and we'll talk about what there is to see here. So the first thing we're going to talk about is going to be the passive. So Legendary Chris is going to be a ranged DPS, and on his passive, he is going to have increases the crit rate of all allies with his King of Darkness. So King of Darkness, this passive is very powerful, as I'm sure you guys are probably aware, thanks to the fact that Annihilation Knight Delans is one of the most problematic characters in the game currently, and he operates almost solely based on his crits. This is a character that is going to be able to offer you as a passive a increase to your crit for all of your allies on your team. This is a very, very powerful passive and tends to be one of the best parts of the kit when we talk about this character. Not to say that there isn't going to be more to talk about here, but this does tend to be the best option that he has to him. So really, when it comes to this character, being able to increase the crit rate of all of your allies is a big, big deal, and it's of course going to mean that you are going to be able to deal just that much more damage foreseeably in a battle. So in general, good stuff. Now, when we talk about the skills, as I mentioned, this is going to be a ranged DPS character, so let's go ahead and talk about the skills here. We have Sword of the Damned. Now, Sword of the Damned is going to deal damage, and it isn't necessarily a ton of damage, but he is going to deal damage to the target with a 100% chance of decreasing the target's defense. So basically, you are going to be able to decrease the defense of the target, and that is going to scale depending on the level of your Chris. So this is a very nice little skill in general. Being able to decrease your target's defense is always something that you like to see. Now, of course, it isn't going to be dealing a ton of damage, as you guys can see there from the multiplier, but this is going to be something that decreasing that defense in things such as Arena is going to be very potent, so something to keep in mind there. So good stuff starting off the kit. Next up here, we're going to talk about Nightmare Splitter. So this is going to deal a considerable amount more damage. So this is going to deal kind of middle of the road damage, pretty decent damage overall, but not anything to write home about. But it's going to deal it equal to his attack. that is distributed among all enemies within a circular range around the target. So basically, this is going to be a distributed amount of damage, meaning that if you hit the entire team, that 336% that you see there, and of course, always keep in mind that these numbers change based on the skill levels of the character, but basically, if he were to hit the entire team, that is going to get split into quarters amongst all four of the teammates for the other team, or if it's hitting just one character, they're going to take the full amount. So keep that in mind. So this is going to be an AoE, and it is going to be in a circular range, and it's just going to be a pure damage option for him. So pretty good stuff. Next up here, we're going to take a look at Black Moon, which is the last of the normal skills. This is going to be increasing our combo chance, so you guys are going to see that we are going to increase our combo chance by a percentage for 25 seconds. So in general, another really nice overall skill. Not much to talk about here. You always like to see the combo chance increase on some of these skills. So for this character, as you guys can probably imagine, he isn't trying to do anything too crazy. He's just trying to help your team do more damage, and he's trying to do more damage himself. So finally here, we're going to have the ultimate, which is going to be Ruler's Judgment. Now this is going to deal damage, and it is going to deal a decent amount of it. As you guys can see there, it is 420% at the skill level 1, but it is going to deal damage equal to a percentage of attack to the target and deals additional damage proportional to a percentage based on the skill level of the skill to the target of the target's reduced HP, and this proportional damage can't exceed 300% of attack. So basically, this is going to be a damage nuke. This is going to be a very strong ability as far as the amount of damage that it is going to be putting out on the field. So in general, again, this is a character that is just going to be a pure DPS option. He has very little in the way of support for the team outside of some of the things we've already talked about. But in general, the biggest selling point, like I said with Chris, is going to be that passive. That tends to be part of the big reason why this character is so popular. Now, when it comes to Chris, though, this particular iteration of Chris, while very strong, isn't necessarily going to be that strong in the meta currently. Now, in the Korean version of the game, this character does end up being a character that ages very well. As new content is released, he ends up being very strong for it. However, in the current state of global, he isn't necessarily going to be all that important right this minute. You know, that is one of the unfortunate byproducts of the way Netmarble is moving the release windows of these characters around, because Chris is very early, comparatively speaking, to when he was released in the Korean side, and so therefore, there really isn't going to be as many of the options in PvE right now for him to shine. So if you are a person that really, really likes Chris, because I know that this is a character that has a lot of fans out there, then you may decide to go ahead and pull for him now. However, if you're somebody that really has no emotional attachment or no interest in the character outside of the fact that you're meta chasing, right now, outside of this character, of course, being another really solid unit for Arena and things along those lines, I would say that this is a character that for right now, if you're wanting to save, you are safe in just going ahead and doing so, because this character is going to be better down the road when more content is released. He is a character that I do feel like eventually you can kind of just wait for a rerun and pull for him then, because he will get rerun again several times, so you don't have to worry about him never coming back or anything along those lines. So kind of keep that in mind, you guys. This is a character that, while very powerful, isn't really all that important right now, and he isn't necessarily going to be able to yield you the best results that he's capable of until we get future releases in PvE. But if you need another really solid option for DPS and things such as Arena, then this is a character that will definitely be beneficial. However, I would say that this is a character that is wholly skippable for now if you're wanting to save. And of course, if you're somebody that's meta chasing, like I said, you're probably better off waiting for a while and getting him later on. But that is pretty much my opinion. Very strong character, but he is one of those characters that right now you could skip out on and wouldn't end up missing out on a ton, again, because not everything has been released that he is going to be useful for. So when it comes to the rest of what we have here, He is, of course, going to be on the Raid Up banner, so that is always something you like to see. Now, his partner here is going to be Delans. Now, of course, Delans is a character, as we are all well aware, is a huge problem, especially in Arena right now for a lot of people. This character is almost a staple. He is arguably one of the best characters in the game right now, currently available. This is a character that if you don't have an Arena, you're probably going to have a hard time. So if you want to pick up Delans right now, now would be the time to do it. So kind of keep that in mind, you guys. That is something that is going to be currently available with this new update on the same banner. So you will have to choose between Chris and Delans. But of course, right now, just with the way things are going in the meta, Delans is of course going to be probably the more important of the two for the moment. But down the road, obviously, like we've mentioned, Chris is only going to get better with age. So one other thing I want to point out here is on the special summons, you are going to see that Ming is currently available. Now, this is the Legendary Plus Ming. This Ming is particularly important for things such as your Arena and so on and so forth. So this is going to be a character that for the moment, you know, if you really, really need help in Arena, she is going to be available on the special summon banner. However, I have told you guys a million times not to pull on this banner. This banner is a pure trap, and I would definitely not be going for her. Do not waste your rubies on this banner. Right now, if you need to pull, if you want to pull, if you got to scratch the itch, Chris is right there. Otherwise, you have a perfectly good Delans just waiting for you, but I would not be going in on that Ming banner. So that is pretty much going to do it for that for now, right, you guys? I don't really think that there's anything else in here that we need to talk about. You know, right now you can go into the general shop. Actually, I guess I can show you guys that right now. If we go down here, I believe that it is going to be in this tab here. If we go down, so you are going to be able to, with rubies, purchase soul stones for some of these Legendary Plus characters. So you'll see Ming is currently available there for some rubies. And then you're also going to see that Delans is available. So you've got your Delans there, and so on and so forth. So basically, this is a very sensitive screen today. It just keeps wanting to click on everything. Anyway, basically, you can use your rubies to purchase some of these soul stones. I do not recommend doing so. If I were you guys, I would go ahead and save your rubies, especially since that is extremely expensive for what they are wanting. 800 rubies for one soul stone. Yeah, I'll pass on that. So anyway, you guys, that's pretty much going to do it for what we have with this latest update. There really isn't a whole lot more to talk about in there. Really, at the end of the day, the biggest part of this is going to be the Celestial Tower has been updated, as well as, of course, Chris being added into the game. I know a lot of people out there have been excited for Chris. However, most of those people have been waiting for Legendary Plus Chris, and you're going to have to continue to wait for just a little while longer. But hopefully, if you're just a fan of Chris in general, then the regular Legendary version will tide you over. He is a very good character, but one that, again, you can go ahead and skip if you need to right now, and just wait till down the road when he gets rerun. And then at that point, maybe wait and see if some of that content has been released, and then he'll probably yield you better results. So anyway, you guys, that's going to do it for me. I hope you all found it informative. If you did, make sure you smash that like button and subscribe. And until the next one, you all take care. Peace. Continue.